हे गाइस, सो टुडे विल सी समथिंग रिलेटेड टू पायरो अगेन. सो इन दिस वन विल सी हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट दिस फायर ऑन द गाय. सी हाउ कूल लेट इट लुक. यू कैन सी दिस. या इट लुक्स लाइक फायर ओनली. एंड ओके, विल स्टार्ट इट. सो स्टार्ट विद द ब्लैंक सीन. So again same, I'll go and import my geometry which I downloaded from Mixamo. You can go and check there. I'll give link in description, so you can go and try those models. If you are like a FX artist, you need some files urgently for work or for showreel, because you can use them as a commercial purpose also and non-commercial also. So you can check their website. That is also Adobe. There is not any fraud website. You can get virus or something. So, and you can download FBX and other formats also. So I downloaded this FBX. So yeah, I'll create a null here. Again, same that character. I'll rename it to Geo. Oh shit. Rename it to Geo. And I'll create a Geo node. So in this one, I'll keep things a bit clean. So I'll give it a green. So yeah, and rename it to, this is a character, so I'll give character. Yeah, so and now inside this again I'll create object merge. So I did R&D for this thing, so I know how much small I have to do this. Otherwise, oh no, otherwise I'll go inside the sorry, I'll create a Tommy. Okay, I'll create in this one also. So you can see we have this. I'll hide other object. You can see we have the geometry, and you can see we have texture also. So that FBX have texture also. So that's why. So after this, you can create a transform node. Transform node, and you can scale it to 0.01. So this is the scale, as you can see in the view. It is 1 and around 2 meter, not even 2 meter. It is around 5.5 feet, or maybe around 6 feet, as you can see. I'll show you Tommy, because the scale matters the most. So you can see this is Tommy, this is our character, so it is around same size. So now I'll show you how you can create fire on some parts. So after transform, first of all I'll create attribute delete, because I don't need any color on this one now. So I'll remove that material from here. And after this, I'll do one thing. I'll use a paint node which is changed in this version of Houdini 18. So before, we have very low settings, like we don't have this much settings in paint. So you can see I can change this to color, and you can see this everything is black, and I can go and paint white wherever I need fire. So I'll paint here. I'll paint some here, wherever you want, fully artistic choice. And yeah, people told me that I have to render things. So bro, if I start rendering all this, because you also know Houdini and my PC is good but not that good, so it is taking too much time for render. So I'll show you how it will look in render, how you can change that setting so it will look some crispy fire in render. I'll show you one or two frame also from render, but if I start doing sequence, I can't make tutorial also. And I'm also learning Houdini, so I have to also see tutorials and everything. That's why I'm not rendering, because my PC is busy full day. Okay, so we have this, and on hand also. Yeah, a little bit here. So okay, we have this. So what we have to do? Okay, I'll change this to CD. I don't know why this bug. I don't know if this is bug or what. See, that color removed automatically. Okay, so what we'll do? This attribute is CD. If you see. Now, if I'll. Okay, first of all, I'll go and paint black here. So, I'll. You can press shift and left click and drag. So, your. This brush size radius you can change. Okay, so we have this. Now I'll go and make it. Okay, shift again. Yeah, You can see we have to paint here. And yeah, it has animation also. I didn't show you animation for this geo. Maybe. Okay. So we have this animation. It is falling. It is dying animation. You can go and search in Adobe MixDemo. That is free. Just you have to log in your ID with your Google account or whatever you want. You can even log in with Facebook also. And as you can see, if I'll go in geometry spreadsheet, we have some values in CD attribute in a point level. So what I'll do after this, I'll create a delete node, and you can change it to primitive point, it will work. So I'll change it to delete by expression, and you have to put here at CD is greater than 0.1. You can see this is deleted something. So what we have to do, you have to go here and delete nodes non-selected. So we got the geometry. So what this is saying whatever is greater than the value of 0.1, or maybe I can do less than also, anything will work. So that thing should delete. So that's why it deleted, and we got some geometry. If you are feeling like it is jagged, so you can do and subdivide it, but not needed for me at least. This is okay. So after this, I'll create a scatter node. Yeah, so we have some points. I'll make it 5000. Okay, it increased or not? Yeah, it increased. So I'll go for maybe 8000. Yeah, so we have some points. Now I'll convert them to pyrosource, and yeah, they have animation also, you can see. And they are the same particle. So sometimes what is happening when you are doing alembic, this particle also change, but I hope these are okay. Yeah, so in after a scatter, what we have to do, we have to create a pyro source as like always. So I'll create tutorial on sparse also, that is even faster cause that is using only the portion. I'll show you okay when I'll do create a tutorial on sparse, which is this one. I'll show you what is sparse. So this is where. No, not here. One sec. Shit. So yeah, you can see here we have a smoke object with sparse pyro solver sparse. I'll tell you how you can use this one. This is also so efficient for now, because if you have low end PC, you can try that. Cool tutorial. There is a lot of tutorial on sparse, so I'll also create one so you can learn from that. So what I'll do, I'll create fuel and I'll delete the density, which I don't need. I need just temperature and fuel. And what after this, first I'll create a rasterize attribute, and I'll put here, oh not this, density, temperature, fuel and velocity. So we have something which is so big. So first of all, click on normalize by clamped coverage. Still it is so big. What you have to do, you have to go and decrease the particle size. So you have something, and this resolution also I need 0.01. You can see we got our source. So when we have to create fire, you can use one more thing, which is attribute noise. After pyro source, you plug this, and what you have to do in attribute from CD, change it to temperature and fuel. So this is important thing to do in this one, and I'll change this to 1D noise, and this is animated, and I have to remap it to -1.5 to 1.5. You can play with this value, and this distribution also we can give some. Maybe this one like this, and in between I want less. Yep. So we have this, or maybe more or less. Yeah. And this one. Mm-hmm. So we have this. After this, I'll decrease this pulse duration and this element size also. So we have more. So, and you can even offset if you find that okay, I need noise in different pattern. And we have this. So now if you'll go here and play, you can see some animated source. So we have now animated source. So yeah, this will also do a lot of changes in your simulation. Because you have some, okay, maybe you can see, if we'll go attribute noise, you can see these trails, okay, no, yeah, so after this you have to create one more thing, which is point velocity, okay, I'll plug this, and now you can see, yeah, so now you can see we have something. So what we'll do, I'll do set to value, and in curl noise what I'll do, I'll add some curl noise in this, so you can see here, and I'll increase the turbulence, I'll decrease the pulse duration, maybe 0.25, and this is scale, if I'll make it more, no, one is okay, and this is also animated, as you can see, if I'll play. Yeah, so this is animated. So this is your velocity, point velocity. That's why I took V here, because we have velocity. You can middle click and you can see fuel temperature and velocity. We don't have density, just I put here, because we didn't create density here, temperature and fuel only. And null, which is source. So later we can play with these value if you feel like, okay, this is not cool. So in DOP network, I'll select and color this one also to purple maybe, or maybe I'll go for orange, yeah. So inside this again, I'll create a smoke object, yeah. And after this, you can take this, or you can directly select this and type what we need, pyro solver, and shift enter, so it will automatically connect, yeah. And after that, I don't need gravity in this case. I need a ground plane and I need a merge. Ground plane, and yeah, remember this ground plane, when you use a merge in this type of situation, what is do? It change automatically. If you remove this, you see these are not like that. If you'll use in geometry, context, it is different. In dynamics, it is different. You can see here it is showing left input affect right input. So if I'll plug this one first and this one second, it will not work. So always remember this thing. And if you have confusion like what I have to do, what else, so you can do here and change it to mutual. Automatically, it will do work for you. You don't have to do anything. So I need a volume source, which I'll connect in the last input. Yeah, and I need a gas resize fluid dynamics, which is this, and I'll plug this to pre-solve and L to layout it. So we have everything, just we have to go and find our object, which is in character source. So this dot 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 means you are going one step back, then you find this character node, then inside that source null. Okay, so we have this. Again, what we have to do from this, you have to change it to source fuel, which we found. And okay, so we have gas resize, so I'll clamp to maximum, I'll remove this one so it can expand how much it want, and I'll make it 2. So what delay frames to, like when you start the simulation, it is if it doesn't find any source, sometime like in this case source is not like from starting. I'll show you what I'm telling. I'll go 0.1 and I'll see where is my box. Yeah, so one more thing, I don't like this ground plane. So what you can do, it will work, but you can click on here, display proxy geometry, so it will hide this, but still it is there, it will work, but you can't see that one. So first of all, I'll copy this parameter and paste relative reference, and I can divide it by 2 or you can multiply by 0.5. Yeah, so it will be always in the this side. Okay, so I'll go and show all object. You can see how much big we want. We want at least 2. Yeah, and this sides is okay because in starting we have this, and after that it will expand. So in close boundary I'll click, and I'll leave only minus y here, so it will not expand in minus y direction. Otherwise it will expand everywhere. And one more thing, I'll hide this one. Nonsense. Okay, so I'll go again in .NET. Space and F to focus this thing. So we got everything, and as you can see it is 0.1, which is I hope not that much. We need 0.05, and this gas resize is set, volume source is also set, and pyro solver. Okay, we'll see first we'll see how it looks like. So I'll play. You can see this is so, yeah, first of all there is no resolution, and hide the grid, you can see now. So I'll play, and one more thing, first I'll go in a smoke object and change it to multi field, and same density and diffuse field also density, and in emission you can make it temperature, which I'll give a value of 10, and I'll give it heat here. And I'll click here so I can range it. So if I'll play now, you can see we have something, and you can range it. What is range? See, so it will move this side. Now it is taking 0 to 1 value in this ramp. If you'll increase this, you can see what is the effect. So I'll make it 50 and see how it works. Yeah, I'll make it 0.1. How? So it is taking this much part only, you can see. So what, I'll make it 0.2, and I don't like this color, I need more orangish. Yeah, you can see, and you can see this resolution is also not cool. So what I'll go for around 0.25, then maybe we can see some. Yeah, this is okay. And yeah, also I'll on this character so you can see this. So after attribute, after transform, I'll create a node which is null, and I'll name this to police. Okay, so we can see this now, and I'll make it to smooth shaded so we don't have that wireframe on the character. And if I'll play, you can see we got something, because I didn't use any micro solver till now. So in this tutorial I'll not use the pyro solver shape node. I'll remove this also. I'll create those micro solver, because they have some more settings. Even I can get those settings in this one also, but I'll show you the another process. So you can see this is the velocity update. So in this one, first of all I need a gas disturbance, gas dissipate, and gas disturbance also. Yeah, as you can see. And I need a gas turbulence, so I'm using 3 now. And I'll create a merge node to merge all 3 together. You can use this technique also, which I use. Yeah, and press L again to layout it. So we have something. So you can see diffusion I don't want. I need this evaporate rate, which is 0.1. And see, in this gas disturbance the strength is too high, it is 25. And this control field also, see, there is a lot of things are not set in this one, so you have to set them. Yeah, so this control field, maybe one sec. Yeah, so this control field, you can put anything, it depends what you are doing. Like you can put here velocity, you can put density. So I'll put density here, and we'll see how it works, because if you'll go there, you can see in this one also we have same setting. If I'll go and click on disturbance, you can go in disturbance, you can see field to disturb, they are working on velocity, temperature. So you can use velocity, temperature, whatever needed, whatever you like. So in a scale, okay, I'll play this once again, I'll see what is the difference. Okay, so we have something not looking so cool because I'm working on density, that's why I'll change it to velocity. Okay. Okay, so more settings we have to do. First of all, so what we have to do, first I'll go and change the combustion setting. First in simulation, make it 2 of this buoyancy lift, otherwise it will go too much high. And in combustion, I'll make burn rate to 1, and this gas release to 5, and this flame height to 1. Now you can see there's a lot of changes in this one. As you can see, I changed the burn rate, how it looks now. So go in smoke object, and inside this I'll make temperature 5, not 10, and this I'll make it 5, then 3. Yeah, this is okay. You can see the disturbance. Yeah, too much disturbance. So I'll go to object level and I'll show you how it looks now. And we are in a high resolution still. Low resolution. We can go to 0.01. Whatever you saw that video, I'll show you again. Which is this one. No. Why it is not playing? Yep. So you can see this video, in this one also this is on 0.01, and I found that render also looks so cool. And you can see here also in this one on left side and everything, that flickering is this is not even flickering, this is like when that fuel is we created that noise because of that this thing is happening, that's why we are getting this cool effect. So we'll see, still we don't have any detail or something. We'll see what we'll do for this thing. So I need only 90 frame or maybe 90 frame. I checked because that animation till 75, so I'll go for 90, not too much. So we can play this and we can see. So we are getting something, but it doesn't look that cool how much we want. So one more thing, in dopnet we can go and make this maximum to 0.25, see what we'll get. There's a difference. You can see this white smoke we are getting, which we need in fire. A little, not white smoke, it is a black smoke, but I need a very little bit, not too much. So if you will change this maximum, how much you will go less, you will get more and more of this. See, if I'll go 0.01, see, sometime you can use this value also. I'll go 0.25, and this is for visualization purpose, you know. You have to do all those things in shader also, then you will get all those effects. So we have this, okay. Now what I'll do, I'll go again in Pyro Solver, and this is okay, and we don't have to change anything here for now. This gas release also, I'll go for 3 maybe, because I hope this is releasing too much of gas. We don't need that much. We use maximum this value for explosion. We make it 150 for big explosion, then we'll decrease it. But in this case, we don't need that much value also. Yeah, you can see we have something. Yeah, so now we can go to turbulence and increase this scale to 0.8 maybe. We can go 0.5, and swill size should be 0.8, grains, pulse, turbulence I hope 3, and you at last we can visualize this. What is happening? I'm getting some issue also, I don't know. See, I can't click on the visualization. Okay, we have this. I forgot. So I'll play this. You can see our turbulence. I'll hide for now so we can see the simulation better. Play again. So we have something. I'll take a small play blast so we can see the speed, because the speed matters the most. We can't feel the speed here, but in this one, first change it to 24 frame and play it. Yeah, it is okay, but I feel this is so, yeah, so it is a little bit fast. So what I can do, I can slow it by changing. First of all, you can see what is happening. Our disturbance field also, this strength is too much. We need maximum 0.8 maybe. Yeah. And I'll play this. Don't need that much of strength. That also speed up your simulation if you have too much disturbance. And yeah, block size also. Did I change block size? Where is that value? So I'll change it to block based and I'll make that 2.0.1. And so what it will do, block size is like the disturbance size. So if you'll make it smaller, you have a small disturbance. So I can use one more disturbance and I'll give it a more value, and I can merge and again connect to this merge. So we have both big disturbance and a small disturbance. Okay, I'll go 0.2 maybe, that will be better. I need more resolution, I can't see things that much clear. Volume source, we don't have to. Okay, I'll make this temperature little bit less. I want 0.5. velocity is okay, and yeah, I need more fuel to burn. So if I'll go to pyro source, I can go and scale it. Oh sorry, this is temperature 1. And this scale should be 2. I need more fuel. And this noise is okay. And velocity also okay. Yep, things are going okay. So now I can go again in Dopnet and check. Yeah, so more fuel, it start again becoming white because we have more that value we have given. So always it increased. Where is our character? No. Yeah. So with the character, let's play it. We need more resolution also. As you can see, it is not as crunchy as you saw in that video which I showed you. So first let it play. See, we have some these streaks which we want. And yeah, it also based on resolution and substeps also. You have more substeps, it will calculate again and again. You'll get a better result also. Okay, go and play it. Up there is that curl noise in point velocity. I have to change that a little bit. So we can get that proper, you can see, and change it to 24 again. So my character I downloaded by mistake in 30 FPS, I realized later. So that's why, and you can see, yeah, this is just because that attributes, that point velocity I gave, and that curl noise is animating so fast, so I have to change it. That's why it has so much of the motion. So what I'll do, I'll go to our point velocity and you can see these streaks. You can see how much fast it is animating. Yeah. So I'll do some settings, I'll change it to scale to 0.5 maybe, and this pulse duration I'll make 2. How it looks, check. Nope, it should be 0.75. As you can see, now it is okay, it is not so fast. And still size, if I'll make it 5, how it looks. Now, I need 0.75 this also. Yeah, little bit of small swill. And turbulence is okay, grains is okay, everything other is okay. Set value 0. So it is fully controlled by curl noise, there is no value in default value. So again, I'll go back to the character and select the police guy. Go back. Now I'll play. You can see there's change in the simulation. And yeah, I have to do some changes in dissipation also. Yeah, as you can see, it changed a bit. It is not that much noisy. And play. Yep. Okay. Play it. Yeah, you can see we have noise, but not that much. So now it is balanced. We need noise, but not that much. Before it was. Okay, I'll do one setting also. Maybe I can do. There is no FPS setting. Why? I thought there should be a FPS setting here. It's okay. I'll see that where I can find that. Because again and again I have to change this. Yeah, so I'll go in DOPNET. I'll do a little bit more changes. I'll go and decrease this to 0.05. Oh, sorry. 0.25. So it will evaporate fast. And this disturbance also, its strength is point. I'll increase it a bit and control this velocity. Because now these are also changed, they are not like in 17, so that's why I have to find, because I am generally not using them a lot. Okay, so control setting, turbulence setting, I'll make this one also 0.65 maybe. Swill size is okay, pulse length is okay, speed is okay. I'll decrease the turbulence. Yeah, so you can see how it works. And I'll go for a little bit less resolution, what I want for the final at least. And I hope one more thing I'll do, I'll go to character. Yeah, and this rasterize. So you can see this is also a bit blocky, you can see my source, that's why there is some issue also. So what I'll go for 0.5. You can see now we have some this thing, and I'll go 0.05 0.08 0.75. yeah, so this should be the source, because before this is so blocky also and so big also, that's why. So now it will take time, so I'll pause the video and I'll show you what is the play blast for the thing, because it will take time. So guys, I'm back, and I did not to completely, but 28 frame, you can see. And I did a little change, not too much, a little change behind the scene, you can say. You can see this wire looks now on that video, looks like that video. So if I'll tell you what I did, so I removed this disturbance because I don't know, in new node there is some issue, or maybe I don't know some settings. So I generally went inside this pyro and I use this one only 0.25, and this block size to 0.1. I don't know what happened to there, because before it was okay, now I don't know. I have to see, maybe in next pyro tutorial I'll use this micro solver and I'll tell you how to use them perfectly. And yeah, one more thing what I did, I change this noise a bit, curl noise, so 0.15, and I decrease the size That's why that issue was there, so that was so big and that roundness. So now you can see it is looking nice. Yeah, we need these streaks and this thing. Yeah, so what I'll do, I'll on this frame only I'll take this first I'll create a geo node, and inside that I'll create a DOP import field. So DOP import field for liquid and this pyro thing. And what I have to do, I have to go $$ and click and choose it to pyro. Wait, start cooking. Oh shit, why it happens. So I'll remove this one. Yeah, so just wait a second, I don't know why when I did this it automatically recached. I didn't change anything. Okay, just wait, it will not take time, I hope. So yeah, one more thing, I decrease the resolution, I increase the resolution, I make voxel size to 0.01. Even we can go much like 0.005 also, if you didn't find that crispiness. But I hope 0.01 is enough for fire, like if it depends on the shot also. If shot is so close, then you have to see how you can tackle, because for close shot people can easily get that okay, this is CG. So okay, I'll take this frame 17. You can see we have some fire, and in geo I'll change it to fire, and this is the render node, so I'll select this and make it red. As you can see we have this. I'll go to material palette and I'll take the fireball shader and I'll apply to the fire. In render, go and select this to fireball to apply the shader. And we need a skylight and we need a grid, which I'll scale it to 10. Yeah, so we have the setup. And one sec, so I'll create the camera also with this angle, I hope. Yeah, this view will go to render view, select the cam and go to out context and create a mantra node. It came and everything is set, just go and render it. It will take a bit of time. So see how it looks in starting, then we'll change some settings. As you can see, first of all it doesn't look like fire. So I'll go first and I'll increase the density scale to 1. And one more thing I'll do, I'll shift and do this left click drag, so we can only render this part. Yeah, so you can see there is things, but this doesn't look that cool. So what, first of all I'll go and increase the scale to 6 and you see what happened. Yeah, this has more glow. Okay, and again the same thing, I'll go and change it to orangish a bit. Yeah, and what I'll do, I'll go to smoke field, use lookup ramp and see what is lookup ramp now. Even I'll go closer and I need this much only. Yeah, you can render it fast. Yeah, so what this do, if I'll make it 0, one sec, okay, I'll select this and delete, see what is the difference. You didn't get that density, outside density, whatever, you are getting black. And so I'll change it to heat, I hope. Or okay, I'll know, I'll go okay, I'll change it to density again. Not density, stop, and I'll take it to density. So leave this one for now, I'll show you what we have to do. remove this. Okay, go to file intensity and go to use lookup RAM. And what we do, I'll decrease this. Render it. So we'll find the proper curve, what we have to give for the lookup RAM. So it will look cool. It is rendering or not? Yeah. I am going to make a tutorial on Pyro Shader, maybe after some tutorials. So in that I'll cover everything, like how you can do for explosion, how you can do for fire properly. This is not as good as you want, and first I'll go and change this scale to 15. So you can see that. Yep. And one more thing, this, I'll go and make this here. I am removing that out density now. Yeah, so you can see there's a bit change in the fire from before, and I'll make a like this and like this. Maybe so you can see we are getting these things how it looks. And one more thing, I'll go and go to OBJ and remove this grid for now, because this is white, so that fire doesn't look that cool in if your background is so bright. When we are doing shots in a studio also, so if your background is so bright like this, so I did fire in a movie, so in that background or in that what you can say environment, that is the daytime, I have to fire something, so in that case also that fire doesn't look that cool, because fire is best at the night time. You can, if in morning time, if you'll put glow and everything also, then also that doesn't look that cool. So that's why I'm using black background, so you can see that will look much better than this white background. Yeah, you can see, you have more volume also, you can see here and here. Yep, and I'll render completely once. So this lookup ramp is important, you have to know how to use this. Yep, and maybe not this one. This one is enough. And in temperature field also, we can use lookup ramp, and we can use it like this. So it will affect the temperature. This is working on temperature. You can see how it changes when I did this one. If I'll make it more, you can see how it will work. So what is happening, temperature is so low in mid area and then it will go high. So not like this, I'll make like fire, so which is like this, then this, then this. So in one frame you can't even judge that shader also. I'm just showing you, this is not like advanced shading, for that I'll make a proper tutorial for shading only, for only Pyro shader, and later we'll also learn Redshift and Arnold. So what, one more thing I'll do, one more thing you can do, you can, if you give final scale, so it will multiply this thing, so see how it looks. Yeah, your fire is so bright now. You can go to general and decrease this to 1. No. So I'll take less. Go 1.5, not too much. Yeah. And so main thing we have to change here only in heat. If I'll increase this to 25, we'll get Yeah, so this is one frame render, so that's the thing. In one frame we can't even just the shader, so we have to find the yeah, for now I hope it is okay. And what we can do, we can decrease this thing a bit. This is same like that, we have opacity ramp in Maya. But we can't use same curve like in Maya because this everything works differently. And you can use this fit range also. I can make it 0.1. You can see how it works. So it will take a source range. So it will take a range of 0 to 1. Then whatever target range will give. So you can see that removed. If I'll make it 5, how it works. It will be more. You can see. Yeah. So that's how it works. So I'll go for 0.75. Yeah, you can see. Yeah, so that's the thing, you can change a lot of things with the shader also. That's what I said. If your resolution, it is not like you have to crank your resolution and it should look perfect in the viewport, because viewport setting, there's a setting in viewport. So you can go to texture and you can see I changed this one, because if you see in your setting it is 128 128 and 128. So this is a limit resolution, so don't bump up too much. It depends on your PC, which type of PC, how much better PC you have. So if you will bump it to like I did 2K and my PC crashed, so I decreased it. So why I did, because I want to see how it looks in viewport. If I'll decrease this one, it will start showing some blocky and pixelated result, so I can't fully judge how it is looking. So that's why. And you can see our shader also look good for now. So yeah, this is our tutorial, and if you like this one, then I'm happy if you like it. And yeah, thanks for the support. So you can see our shader also look good, and this fire also looking good. Yeah, you can see now it looks like fire. So this is yeah, one more thing I'll show you, that why you should not do that. So if I'll go and change this to 128 128 and 128 and save as default and cancel this and go back and play, so that resolution you can see now. This is the thing. Okay, I'll go and I'll delete my skylight and sunlight both. Yeah, you can see now resolution. And if I'll go to 1K, I'll show you 1K also, maybe my PC can handle that much. So I have a 32 GB RAM. So you can see you have more crispiness here, you can see, but you can't see. So try to not use this value a lot. You can go and always check your this for Pyro in render. That is much better, I hope. But if you crank it up, you maybe your file, because see I didn't even save the file, so if it will crash I have to do the thing again, and that's bad habit. And one more thing I did, I forgot to tell you, in .NET, so what is happening before, when I was caching, is what is this scratch cache. So what was happening, when it is going like 30 40, so it is not like it is like I have cache from 25 to 40 only. We don't have cache this side. So what is happening, it is if you see default it is 5000, so I bump it to 20000, which is 20 GB. So what is happening, now it has it has a storage of 20 GB, so it can store 20 GB of cache. So before it was 5000. So you maybe you also tried, if you are going high resolution and you are simulating for the high frames, like you are going 100 frames 200 frames, so it start leaving that last portion, it start moving with the this blue line start move, and when you escape or stop it, so it will automatically remove fully cache. So that's why I bump it up, so you can see that. If I'll go for 90 frame also, now it will not remove. So this is also a small tip if you are having trouble with this thing, because it happens a lot in starting. I also don't know these things. These are very small things. If you use a lot, then you will get a small problem, then you can tackle those. So you can see our fire is done. So thanks for watching, and we will do our shader tutorial also, Pyro shader. And yeah, thanks.